Welcome to episode 9. Let me begin by asking you a question. Are you having difficulty in attracting customers to your business? Are you having difficulty in generating lead for your business? Then permit me to share with you a solution which can tame the problem. Growth hacking is a mindset where every decision that a company takes is geared towards growth, and that too at marginal cost. But remember, a prerequisite for successfully executing growth hacking is the presence of a great product. Has any company embraced growth hacking and succeeded? Well, not one company, but several companies which touch our life have embraced growth hacking and succeeded absolutely big time. Take Dropbox. Dropbox created an awesome product and it decided to give a part of that free to the initial users. Because the product was good, the users had a great experience and they went and spoke about it to other people. When real people speak good things about a brand, the believability improves and therefore more users came on Dropbox platform. Result? Dropbox was able to attract more and more people on his platform. But Dropbox also executed another strategy to accelerate growth hacking. Whenever any of its existing users spoke good things on the social networking site, Dropbox rewarded these specific users with additional space. What was it trying to achieve? It was trying to reward a behavior which Dropbox wanted to see more of. Over a period of time, Dropbox aggregated on its platform users who were raving about what a great product Dropbox was, and this raving was getting more and more users onto Dropbox platform. What were the benefits for Dropbox? By pursuing this strategy, the cost of customer acquisition for Dropbox fell and the lead generation cost also fell. From Dropbox, let's move to Gmail. When Google introduced Gmail, it followed a different growth hacking strategy. And the strategy was to make Gmail available not free as Dropbox had done, but to make it available only by invitation. When Gmail was available by invitation, it put into play a behavioral sciences concept of scarcity effect. Anything that is scarce becomes more valuable to us. Result? People were asking their friends if they could source an invitation for them. Result, there was an aspiration to get onto the Gmail platform. Today, when you look at Gmail, its growth hacking strategy has worked so well that at near zero cost, it's gone on to become the largest email platform in the world. I see a lot of you starting to believe in growth hacking. But some of you may erroneously surmise that growth hacking is only for technology companies. Nothing can be further from the truth. Blue-blooded brick and mortar companies have embraced growth hacking and achieved great results. Take Reliance Infocom. When a person on a Reliance platform made a call to another person on Reliance platform, the call was free. This encouraged the organization to shift all its people, no matter which platform they were onto the Reliance platform, believing, and rightly so, that whenever any communication happens within an organization, the bill would be extremely low. This encouraged an organization to make sure that every single employee moved from whatever platform they were onto the Reliance platform. And excellent execution of growth strategy. And how much did it cost Reliance? Marginal cost. I hope I have been able to convince you regarding growth hacking. Growth hacking, remember, is a mindset. As a growth hacker, every decision that you will take will be geared towards growth, and that too at marginal costing. But do not forget the prerequisite for growth hacking. You need to have a product that will deliver a memorable experience to your customers. More and more brands that we admire have adopted the growth hacking mindset. So if you do not want to be left behind, acquire the growth hacking mindset now. I wish to thank you for the feedback that we've received for these videos. Do continue to send your feedback. It means a lot to us. And of course, remember to subscribe to our channel.